So let's continue on with our examination of different algorithms for computing matrix-matrix multiplication. This time we're going to look at how C can be computed one row at a time. Recall how the ij entry of C is computed as the dot product of the current row of A with the current column of B. Now let's look at a concrete example where we're computing a 4x2 matrix C, and we're going to update it by doing A times B with matrices with the indicated entries. And the loop for computing this is given below it. Okay, if we concentrate on the loop index with I, then what we see here is that we can march across the ith row one element at a time. And then for each entry in that row, we're going to have to perform a dot product to update that entry. And that's then done by the loop index with P. Let's illustrate this. Okay, we start by setting I and J to 0. We then update the first entry of C. We do so by taking these dot products of the ith row of A with the jth column of B. Then we move on to the next element, and notice that we're going across rows now. We do another dot product, and we move on. The important thing to notice here is that we're computing C one row at a time. So let's focus on the double loop around dot products. Okay. So what we can do is we can replace that entire inner loop by the dot product that computes it. And you're starting to realize that there you could have called the dot routine that we developed earlier in the course. So if we do that, then we just do our dot products to update the entries of C, and again, pay attention to the fact that we're marching across rows of C. So now we can look at the single loop around what's going to turn out to be a row vector times a matrix product. Okay, if you look at the row that's being computed of C, that turns out to be just the corresponding row of A times the matrix B, updating that row of C. So this double loop is actually simply implements a row times a matrix product adding to the appropriate row of C. And we can animate that as follows. We could have gotten here by taking matrices C and A, partitioning these matrices by rows, and then remembering how to do a partitioned matrix-matrix multiplication. If we then focus on what computation needs to be performed, we notice that C can be updated one row at a time. So we would loop over the rows of C, and each individual ith row of C would then be updated by the corresponding row of A times the matrix B, updating that row of C. And then we could expand how that row times matrix multiply is actually implemented as a doubly nested loop. But notice that there's two orderings. You could have the loop index with J on the outside for that double loop, or you could have the loop index with P on the outside for that double loop. So the detail of how the row times matrix multiply is implemented doesn't need to be exposed if we just think of it as a row times a matrix multiply. So this picture here summarizes it all. Okay, on the left we have matrix C. The red boxes indicate the rows of C, and what we notice is that those can be computed by updating with the corresponding row of A multiplying the matrix B.